So if you're involved in the Rec'em community in any way through YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, I don't even know, TikTok,
Reddit.
then you probably know about this hashtag save the room or save Rec'em. I don't know. What I've got from it's a team of people that are trying to make Rec'em good again by hurting it. I don't know. Toaster seems to have some sort of big impact in it, being leader, whatever. I don't care. All I know is that he had a impact in it, and he doesn't have the
Toaster
best
is a fucking
reputation in the Rec'em
egotistical
community.
basement.
And personally, I think this whole Save Rec'em thing is really stupid, and whoever's behind it, whoever's supporting it, like, in the end of the day, you need to get a hobby, man. I'm sorry. But what I do want to talk about is that the reason that Rec'em is dying isn't all necessary Rec'em, but it's our fault. Whoa, 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 don't go hating in the comments right now. The video just started. You can wait till the end to do that. But I'm not saying Rec'em doesn't have a hand in making their game worse in the past couple of years. But, like, if you look at the Steam charts, the player count hasn't, like, the active player count hasn't really had a big shift of more players or less players than it was in 2022. I'm not here to talk about statistics. I don't know much about that. I'm here to talk about why we and, well, you, Jimmy, think I don't see you, are the cause of Rec'em dying. There's a lot of things I want to go over in this video, and this is going to be a big yap session, so if you don't care, you don't have to watch it. I don't really care. One thing that recently got a lot of players mad at Rec'em is the whole removing weekly thing. This started a while back when they switched it from weekly to monthly, and people were not happy about that, especially since the stuff they were putting out, a lot of it was kind of dookie, you know. But me personally, I never really did the weeklies, so I didn't care that much. They also said they were going to make it better. They're gonna revamp the system. And people were like, what? But, like, let's be honest, the system kind of was trash. It sucked. I don't want to play 5 Rec Rally games for a shitty skin. I don't want to play 1 Rec Rally game for a shitty skin. For any skin. So if they are working on a system, and if that means temporarily disabling it so they don't have to worry about it, and they can shift all their attention on that side of the game to making it better, making better challenges, making it more intuitive, then go for it. I can live without it for a couple months, for how long it takes. That one is more of a Rec'em side, I won't lie. That's not too much of our fault, but a lot of these are. The part that's our fault is not realizing that Rec'em is a game, and sometimes it's not that easy to just keep it going. You don't work there, you don't know what it's like, but I don't either, so. Next thing. Bad rooms. Specifically cash grabs, such as like the costume maps, whatever. If you don't like the rooms, you don't gotta play. I get why people would make those. They wanna get their bag. Rec'em made it really easy to make money. Be grateful that you can make money in Rec'em in the first place. A lot of games don't do that, especially free games. But really, you don't have to play these games. Yeah, Rec'em is pushing them out, but I did see things where they were trying to fix that. If nobody plays the games, they're not gonna recommend them. It's not that difficult. Just don't play the game. They're not forcing you to play the game. You don't get a million tokens if you join the costume map. You just can just ignore it and move on with your day. It's not that big of a deal. Items. Oh boy, do people love to hate on the items. Even I wasn't a big fan. Recently, they've been doing like a whole cool pop-up shops like every week, and they look cool, and they add a bunch of items, some new, some old. And yeah, a lot of them are expensive, really expensive. You gotta remember this. Rec'em is a free game. They need to make money to keep the free game running. You don't have to buy any of these. You don't have to spend a penny. If you want to support the game and look cool, you can buy them. It's either that or they make Rec'em like $60 and the cosmetics are cheap. I'd rather have a free game and expensive cosmetics than an expensive game and cheap cosmetics. That's just me. I don't get the big fuss. Yeah, they're slowly raising the prices, but I mean, you don't have to buy them, man. There is a lot of free stuff you can get in Rec'em. You don't even see your body. All you see is your arms, unless you have a camera. Come on now. Unless the full body, but that's different. That's different discussion. If we weren't buying them, they probably would totally lower the prices. Maybe not, but they probably wouldn't care about it that much if we weren't buying them. But we love buying cosmetics. We love buying them and then hating on them after we bought them. So they're gonna keep pushing them out. It's just a big cycle, and we're too dumb to realize that. I quickly want to talk about Rec'em Studio. This is a problem that I think is more on the Rec'em side. I think they should have never made it available to anyone that has a computer, and they should have kept it where you had to sign up, and that would like remove a lot of the cash grab games. A lot of them are just kind of stolen, ripped games from Roblox, put into Rec'em Studio. And when you remember when Rec'em Studio first came out, the best games were like the ones you had to sign up for because they had actual good creators making them. But that's, I could make a whole nother video on that, and I might. So yeah, next thing. What should actually happen, especially with this save Rec'em thing? I know this video is supposed to be about that, and I started rambling, but this is more about it now. I don't know much about it. All I know is that they kind of wanted to like raid the reviews, talk shit, whatever, and then all go on like a July 6th and like go in the game, which I don't know what that does, and like protest or something. Like, I don't, Rec'em doesn't care if you all play the game. That helps them if you all go in the game at one day. If you really like didn't like the game, just don't play it. That would hurt them. What you really should do, if you don't enjoy Rec'em, don't play it. I know, that was crazy. But all these people hating on it, like, there's a bunch of free VR games. Try that, or just don't play VR. If you can't take a break from Rec'em, but you can't stop hating on it, Rec'em can't be that bad of a game. Like, it shouldn't be that hard if you genuinely don't like the game to just take a break from it and play something else or just do something else. That's what you really should do. Just take some time away from the game or just leave some constructive feedback, positive feedback. Don't just go raiding the servers because that's obviously not going to help. They don't care. You're just one of million players. Couldn't care less. But if you actually tried to think of positive things, positive actual good feedback to give them, maybe they will start to listen more. I mean, they just dropped a whole Rec'em original, but nobody cares because the item costs 10,000 tokens. Like, they just dropped a free game and you care about a stupid shirt that costs 10,000 tokens that you don't have to buy when they just dropped the whole game for free. The 10,000 token item funds the free game. It's worth it. You don't even have to buy the thing. I don't even know. And first off, Rec'em isn't in a great state right now, especially because of this. And what do? We turn on each other. How is that going to help the game if we turn on each other? The players that play the game are going against each other. It's the whole team, save Rec'em, team, it's shit. I mean, I don't like it, but like, why can't we just not do that? That's not going to make Rec'em better if everybody hates each other. There's no point in it. This whole save Rec'em thing, just don't play the game, man! I'm not even, like, on a side. I'm trying not to be on a side, even though I think it's dumb. Why can't we just, like, all be chill? You know what I mean? I have no hate to anyone doing that thinks the game is bad. But you don't need to try to ruin it for the people who enjoy the game. Is what I'm really trying to say. I want you, look at me. Rec'em is a free game. You don't have to play the game. They gotta make money somehow. These are the best ways for them to make money because it doesn't actually affect you. You don't have to buy this. You could have fun, play the game just like anyone else would. They would just look different because they spent hundreds of dollars of their life savings. They didn't go to college because they used their college tuition money to buy Rec'em clothes. But at the end of the day, it's the same game for you too. If you want Rec'em to be $60 and have cheap cosmetics, go for it, man. I don't know. Make your own Rec'em. There's a lot of things going on here. There's a lot of hate, a lot of negativity. I just think we need to sit down and breathe. I think the main reason a lot of people think about this is because they miss the old days at Rec'em. Or they just miss those days where they could just get on Rec'em and play games with friends and have a good time. I think what we all really need to just do is just get a couple friends. And if you don't have any friends, that's not Rec'em's fault. And just play a game and just have fun with them. With just that small group of friends. Because I think that's what really made Rec'em special in the first place. Those games you played 1, 2, 3 years ago probably still exist. So why don't you just have fun with the few friends that made Rec'em special again? Because just think, everybody making a video about Rec'em, if there was no Rec'em, you wouldn't be able to make a video. All these YouTubers with hundreds of thousands of subscribers, or any amount of subscribers, anyone you met for Rec'em, if there wasn't Rec'em, if you haven't downloaded this free game, you wouldn't know about them, or your channel wouldn't have any of the Rec'em content that it does. So instead of just hating and trying to save Rec'em, I think we just need to appreciate what we have while we have it. So Rec'em, thank you for everything you've done for me, because everybody that I talk to, that I play games with, that isn't people that I know, in real life, I met through Rec'em. So I owe everything to this game. Thank you. And thank you for watching. Don't you grow up in a hurry. Your mama be worried. Oh, it was all part of the story. Even the scary nights. Thank you for all of the glory.